womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as the prophet to the nations. Jeremiah 1:5. Such a beautiful verse by the Lord Almighty. The Lord knew Jeremiah even before he was formed in the womb. The Lord knows each one of us even before we are formed in the womb. He has a calling, a vocation, a design planned out for each one of us even before we are born. Hello everybody, I am Steffi Sherry. My husband Sherry John and I, we are blessed with three wonderful children. Maria Sherry, who's 4.5 years of age, Isabel, who's almost turning 3, and Joshua, who's 7 months old. We've been married for 5.5 years. We are still in the process of learning parenting, experiencing the joy of children, adjusting to the various challenges, and still discovering our strengths and weaknesses. So I'm not here to give you any expertise on parenting. All I'm here is to share with you all my testimony, my experiences with God and our children, and also to share a few thoughts and tips that we have, learnings that we have done in our life. Months, we realized we were expecting our first bundle of joy. To be honest, none of our three children were planned children. God has been gracious, and in His designated time, He blessed us with each of our three children. My first pregnancy was by far smooth. I remember during my first pregnancy, Sherry would read from the Bible, St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 1, daily to the baby. It starts with the narration of the message of Angel Gabriel to Zechariah, followed by the Annunciation and then the Visitation. A priest had actually asked us to read this chapter to the baby every day. Here the unborn John the Baptist is the first one to recognize the presence of Jesus in Mary and express his joy. After Maria was born, after my first normal delivery, though my pregnancy was quite smooth, my post-delivery complications were there were a lot of complications post-delivery. I was hospitalized for almost a month, and I developed different clots in my leg. I needed assistance for even rudimentary things. Sometimes it seemed to be fatal. Sometimes I thought I would just not get better from here. All this happened, but we were always supported by prayers from family and friends. We were having a lot of spiritual support. We were having a lot of moral support. But having said all that, that experience after delivery, the hospitalization experience, really scarred us. We were really scared after that as to how so many complications just came in. It was not 1 year after I got healed that we learned we were expecting again. We were very happy, but the doctors, they weren't happy. So we went to multiple doctors, and we had to go to multiple doctors because doctors were not ready to take us as patients after knowing my case history. There were doctors who advised abortion as the alternative. So each time a doctor would do that, we stopped going to that doctor. We were scared, but we surrendered to the will of God. We knew that God was in control, and come what may, we will accept it with grace. We prepared ourselves mentally for the second delivery. I'd like to share that we had a lot of our Jesus Youth friends who took up small prayers for us till the baby arrives. One Hail Mary, one Memorare, one Decade, one Divine Mercy Chaplet. And they used to pray that daily till the baby arrives. So along with me, along with my family, along with Sherry's family, we had so many friends who would take up small sacrifices, take up small prayer intentions, so that, you know, the delivery goes smooth and the baby is all fine. So thanks be to God, my second delivery was really smooth. I had no hiccups, no events. It was, I recovered really well. None of what happened in the previous episode occurred. Though I had braced myself for it, I realized it everything was just perfect, perfectly done by God in His time. I really thank God for that. We didn't have any complications. Thereafter, we again conceived about a year, 1.5 years after that, and now we have Joshua with us. During both the pregnancies, that's for Isabel and Joshua, I had to take injections for blood thinning, and it was painful because I had to take them daily, but I surrendered that pain to God. So there are certain things that we as parents did to bring the child, to bring each child into this world. Just like as parents, we prepare financially, we prepare, we eat good food so that the baby grows physically well. We would also urge you to pray spiritually so that the spiritual nourishment, not only of the child, but also of the parents, to embrace this new child, to embrace this new member of the family, so that, because that's what we are called for. We take so much care to see that the baby in the womb is growing properly. Every scan, every month, every trimester, we pray earnestly that everything is fine with the baby, there's no complications, you know, there's nothing to be worried about. Similarly, we can pray for the baby spiritually. So there are certain things that we did. This could be as a result of our complications in the first delivery, or just prayers that were offered, which helped us a lot in preparing ourselves to receive the new member. So one of the things was to read the Bible daily. What we did was, before Isabel was born, during the pregnancy period, as also when Joshua was born, before that, the pregnancy period, we aimed to complete the reading the entire Bible. So we read the entire Bible for Isabel, we read the entire Bible for Joshua. What we believe is they are hearing the word of God. It's a spiritual nourishment for them. They are able to hear the word of God through us. They are able to experience God in whatever minute way possible through the reading of the Bible. I know as pregnant women, it's very difficult. We are working. If you have children at home, it's all the more difficult. You get exhausted. You get tired. So what I did was I downloaded an app on my mobile, which had the Bible, the Catholic version of the Bible, and I used to read it whenever I was traveling from work, from home to work, and back from office to home. What Sherry used to do was, in the night after the family prayer, when we were about to sleep, he would read the New Testament to the baby in the night. So I took up the Old Testament, he took up the New Testament, and that way we tried to finish covering the entire Bible. Another thing we did was say 5 mysteries of the rosary and surrender it to God. Surrender everything, all the anxieties that you go through, all that baby is going through, everything to God. So this helped us a lot. I remember there were times during Isabel's pregnancy when I used to develop a very severe stomachache. And instead of getting afraid, it was in the wee hours of the night, I just used to get up and say the rosary. Once the rosary entirely is done, a certain kind of calmness would come into me and the pain would subside. So even psychologically, mentally, it helped me a lot. Another thing that we did was attend a residential retreat during the pregnancy, so that you are able to experience the power of God in you, and you are able to give that blessing even to the child in your womb. Attend daily mass whenever possible. I remember whenever we used to go for mass, when I make the sign of the cross as you enter the church, I made a sign of the cross on the belly. When I receive communion, after receiving communion, I would make a sign of the cross on the belly. After the Kurbana got over, the final blessing, make a sign of the cross on the belly. During family prayer, make a sign of the cross on the belly. Small things, but it actually is small ways of giving Christ to your baby. And I remember in one of the residential retreat during counseling, I told the priest that I'm taking injections daily. The priest said that since you're taking injections daily, why don't you offer every injection that you take for every couple that is without a child and pray for them. Offer those sacrifices to God for all those couples who are yet to be blessed with a child. And this happened for Isabel's pregnancy, and ever since I've been, so after delivery again I have to take the injections for a period of 3 months to stabilize my body. So every injection that I took, I offered it for all the couples who were yet to be blessed with children. When I pray for myself, I pray for all the couples who are expecting children. Another thing, as I mentioned earlier, was the Jesus Youth Friends. They would take up small prayers. I remember we were in a parish during one of the pregnancies, and there is something called the Elizabeth Ministry, wherein there's a WhatsApp group created for all the expecting mothers, and the sisters, the nuns, and the priests would have special service dedicated for them, special prayers said daily, and special prayers said once in a month. So there would be small talk and mass offered for all the expecting ladies. Small things which helped us to go through the entire phase of pregnancy, preparing for the child. Because as mothers, as parents, we have so many anxieties. But all this, I know most of the couples, most of the parents, expecting parents, are doing so many different things in unique way. This was our share of things that we did to give Christ to the newborn in whatever way possible. One last thing I would like to share is when we were expecting our third child, and when the news got out and when I delivered the third child, I had some neighbors, some friends giving me a puzzled look. Why a third child? Don't you have a career? Is this what you're going to do? Look after children and things like that, etc., etc. You know, as myself, as a mother, I may not be able to do many things that I want to do. But if I surrender all my dreams, all my wishes for my children to God and let God take control of it, the grace of God is abundant. He abundantly given to you, because God said, I have come so that you may have life, life in its abundance. If it were only up to me, and Sherry, maybe handling one kid also may be very strenuous. But when it is up to God, He has given them to us. When we are open to life as parents, because that's one of the vows that we took at the altar, right? To be open to life. We don't, because let God's will be done in us. God knows the hair on our head. God knows the tensions, the struggles that we go through. God knows everything. So let God's will be done through us. That is what we've been trying to live our life like. Lastly, Mother Teresa said, why do you save so many children? It is like saying so many flowers in a garden. Surrendering to the will of God, openness to life, is the message that we as a couple, we as parents, would like to share. From the minimum experience that we have, we would like to share this with you all. Praise God.